What's up, food family? It's your boy Clezzy, back with another episode of Show Me Cuisine. But today, we're doing it a new style. It's a bright and sunny Sunday. It's football season. And whenever you're in Kansas City, it's always a red Sunday, always representing those Chiefs. So what we're going to do is a tradition done like no other. Typically on Sundays, Sundays is that Sunday's meal. Mom gets together, grandma gets together, and they pick, I'm telling you, they putting down them true cuisines on Sunday. So today, I'm going to roll up on my aunt and uncle. They supposed to be able to get down when it comes to the get down. And I'm going to see if they can really put together something delicious, fit for football Sunday. Roll with me and find out.
Hey, Bobby, why do you like soul food?
Because it makes me happy.
Pass the peas like he used to say. Pass the peas like he used to say. Pass the peas like you used to say. Pass the peas like you used to say.
So checking Food Mafia, I just pulled up to the spot. We out here in Grandview, in Kansas City. So if you're familiar with the Missouri area, you know exactly where this is. Truman Corners is right up the street. A little bit farther up, you got Belton, Raymore, things of that nature. So I'm about to go ahead and go into this house, see what they doing here in this kitchen. Come on.
You want to
dry?
Go ahead and do it.
And it's crispy. It's crunchy.
You want me to go ahead?
The flavor.
She said the flavor. I tell you what, ain't nothing like tradition. Nothing goes better with fried fish. It's some spaghetti. Look at it. Look.
Spaghetti.
And it's the difference between pasta and spaghetti, particularly in Black households. We got meat in our stuff.
Okay. But,
come on. 1, 2, vegan making some food. 3, 4, can't use dairy no more. 5, 6, better deal with it.
Bumping. Look, got some Monica in the background. That's when you know you cooking some soul food.
It smells good.
Yeah. Got little cuz. I'm telling you, they working it from all stove tops in the house. Look, you can see all your seasonings over here. Look.
Oh goodness, it smells delicious.
Look at that macaroni. So it don't look dry. It look creamy. Look.
This is vegan macaroni.
Come on, vegan.
I have to season a little more, but I just need you to tell me like what do you taste and what you don't taste.
Now go ahead and explain for the viewers what's vegan macaroni. What does that mean?
Basically, I just created a butter and flour.
Come on.
And then I added of course this.
So is it no cheese actually in it?
Yeah, it's like no cheese. I added this. I also added the field roast cheese. It comes in slices. And then this one comes in blocks. And then I also added this. Usually I would blend up tofu and add it to my roux, but since I didn't have two of these, I didn't use my tofu.
Gotcha.
What else should I add?
So we've seen the macaroni and cheese, which technically ain't macaroni and cheese. So, hey, it's vegan. I ain't never had it. I'ma try. I'll let y'all know how it tastes. Stay with me. So check it out, Food Mafia. You already know what this is. We're getting them sweet potatoes going. They tearing the kitchen up, making it right. Tune in. We'll let you know how it go. Game time is prep time. Man, look at these things. I'm about to toss these things in.
Get it going.
Unk, how you keep your bread and coating the full fish fillet?
Well, I lick every one first so it sticks to it.
Well, there you go.
It's a secret.
Lick them.
You gotta lick them.
And it'll stick them.
It's finger licking good afterwards.
Check game, food family. You know, whenever it comes to any type of event, any type of dinner, you always got the riffraff.
You do.
They come prepared to eat. But
and
now
prepared to.
But we got some chefs. We got Miss Spaghetti right here.
You see it.
We got the vegan mac downstairs.
You hear them. Tell them what you did in the mac and cheese.
Yep, I did it.
You did it.
I did it.
Capital IT, period.
I did it.
Yeah.
See?
I'm the best man. I did it.
See, around here, these family folk, they teach the kids. It says train up a child the way they should cook.
The way they should cook.
And they will what?
And they will not depart
and
from
it. And they will not. And they will not. So, you know, learn. Look at them. Look what they're doing. They showing me how to fish in the backyard. What? A man who can catch his own fish will not be hungry.
Oh, shit.
Good Bible scripture.
Good girl.
Yeah.
I'm telling you right now, if your macaroni don't move like that, you ain't making macaroni right. It don't matter. Well, check your family. You know, you can't have spaghetti and catfish or bassa without some coleslaw. Look at this. Unk said you got to throw a little bit of pepper on it. You want to really get it, give it that look. This is not a dry coleslaw. This is a creamy coleslaw. Not watery. It is a creamy coleslaw.
Fishing.
I slid in on the side. Look how golden that is.
With the tartar and the hot sauce.
Come on, y'all. Look.
Yeah, about to face that.
And that's another thing you will notice about cookouts.
For me.
They do not think about their safety. They over here burning themselves up
in
grease.
We really in Memphis.
Time to go.
Take it.
My old boy from the point, but I'm from Southwest. And every now and then I get put to the test. But I can't be stopped, cause I gotta come true. Ain't got no gun, but I got my crew. Didn't come for no beef, cause I don't eat steak. I got a plate of soul food, chicken, rice, and gravy. Not covered in too much, drinking a cup of punch. Topical every last Thursday of the
Daddy
month.
Put the hot grits on my chest in the morning. When I was sick, Mary had the hot soup boiling. Didn't know why, but it felt so good. Like some waffles in the morning, headed back to the woods. Now I'm full as a tick, got some soul on blast.
So check it out, Food Family. I done got my plate. You seen the picture. Filled to the rim with some pasta, spaghetti, cabbage, macaroni and cheese, and sweet potatoes. So let's take a taste, and I'll tell you exactly what I think. First things first. Got that fish. It's crispy on the outside. Let's taste the seasoning. See if it was seasoned right. Definitely seasoned well. It's not over salty. It's a mild flavor. Crunchy, crispy, the way that you want your fish. It's delicious. Let's jump into this spaghetti. So now I'm about to jump into this spaghetti. Noodles are cooked well. The meat complements it. The sauce is subtle and delicious. Now I'm more of a heavier sauce type of guy on my spaghetti. But this actually complements the fish very well. I think Lil Cuz really did a good job. The cabbage. How about good? Seasoned. Cooked through. Just wondering if, because most of the time when you're dealing with cabbage, you have it one or two ways. When it's cooked right, it's really soft. But sometimes if you're digging in through the cabbage, and every now and then you get a little harder piece that maybe wasn't cooked as thorough as the other pieces, that's where you run into problems. But this one right here, it was cooked well, it snapped in your mouth, but it wasn't a snap like it was raw. It was a snap like it was cooked well, ready to be eaten, and it was ate. Very good. The mac and cheese, it's creamy, it's thick. Look at that. That's some good macaroni, y'all. That's some good macaroni. Probably has some half and half in it to thicken it a little bit. Beautifully done. And now, you know what you do. Macaroni, sweet potato. That's a good sweet potato. Now, some people like to put a little bit more cinnamon in their sweet potatoes. This one is very light texture, very lightly sweet seasoned, so you really get the full flavor of the actual sweet potato. It's not overpowered by any of the seasonings or any of the flavors. So it's really good. So like I said, depending on who you are, a lot of brown sugar, a lot of cinnamon. Some people like to top it with some type of marshmallows, things of that nature. But this was done, the whole overall experience is whether or not the sweet potato was cooked, and it's cooked. That's the key to a good sweet potato. That it's cooked thoroughly, the way when you put it in your mouth, you can barely put pressure on it and it smashes in your mouth. Yo, this family event this Sunday, fantastic off the wall. I have to give them a recommendation and say, you know what? When I said either claim it or rename it, for this particular family's household, I'm gonna go ahead and claim it. Tune in next time. Holla.
But you don't have to take my word for it.